Welcome to Yuri Experience, and today I want to talk to you about broad range of knowledge. You probably do know some information. You do have some knowledge in your head. You do have some interests which you use in order to find new information in your free time, for example, or during your work if your work correlates with what you are interested in. But there are also people who like and prefer to learn various things from various topics, from various fields of information. They like to gain more information from different sources and different fields. About this group of people, or actually about two kinds of people who belong to this group from time to time, I want to talk about today, because I think that I belong to one of these groups. I'm not sure about which one, but I will talk about that in the end, about what am I in this category. But let's start from the beginning. Let's go. But obviously, before we do so, I have to tell you that this is Yuri Experience, and here I share my various experiences about different topics. I do 2 videos per week, Mondays and Thursdays. If you will enjoy this video, please drop a like. You can also subscribe to the channel. Except for that, let's go. As I mentioned already, today I will cover 2 groups of people. To the first one belong people who are called polymath. There are also a couple of other names, for example, a polyhistor and Renaissance man and a couple of others. And these people are interested in various topics, in big amount of information from different fields. They also use this information and their knowledge to solve the problems. So they basically use combination of knowledge to solve some complex problems. And depending on the definition, they also need to achieve some level of specialty, some level of specialization in some specific field, or actually in more than one field. The most strict definition says that the person shall achieve something in many fields in order to be considered a polymath. So that person doesn't only need to know something from different fields, but also need to bring some achievement into the world, to bring this field of science forward, using the knowledge of different other fields of science, and at its best also does it in different fields. I already used the name Renaissance man, and that name is in a lot of occasions a synonym for polymath, because a lot of people during Renaissance era, Renaissance time, which we learn about, like different famous thinkers, famous artists and whatnot, they were polymath. Usually they did a lot of science, they did a lot of experiments, they were popular in arts and they brought something new to arts. A good example of that would be Leonardo da Vinci, who was a person like, he did a lot and he was actually pretty good in a lot, and a lot of his achievements are up till now very popular things that people think, yes, it was interesting, it was cool, it brought this field further. And up to this day, a lot of people are still saying, okay, his involvement in different fields, his knowledge from different fields brought these fields further. He used his complex knowledge over various topics in order to bring the field, the science, the arts further. A little problem with using this word nowadays is the fact that it is difficult to become so proficient in one specific field in order to bring this field further. Nowadays we know more. We know more about, for example, physics in comparison to Leonardo da Vinci, who made his first experiments. Yes, his experiments are pretty, still really cool and pretty interesting in terms of physics, for example, but nowadays, let's go further, let's go how universe works, why black holes are black holes and what is on the other side on black hole. Like, the topics are really on a different level, which is why in order to know enough about a topic so you can bring this topic further, in order to become some sort of specialist in the topic, you need to invest a lot of time. You cannot be just, I am good in physics. You need to be good in some specific way of quantum physics. You can say that you are a theoretical physicist. And still, a lot of people will ask you, what is your specialization? People who know about physics. they will ask you, okay, where, what actually you are looking into, because as a scientist, you don't normally look overall, everywhere. You are normally looking in some specific field. And same stuff works for pretty much everything as a person of arts. You are normally not working in various different types of arts. No, you normally specialize yourself in this specific form of this specific art. As a person of writing, you normally don't write different various types of books or whatever you write, articles. You normally have some ways or some specialization. So you know, I am good at writing these articles and I'm paid in order to write these articles, so I will do them. Which makes it difficult to impossible to be a polymath in current day. It was difficult during Renaissance time too, because in order to be a Renaissance man, a polymath, you need to know a lot, you need to invest a lot of time in different fields. And in order to do that, you need to have time. In order to have time, you need to have money. And that's pretty much why most of polymath people were royalty or some people of religion in high positions, because other people didn't really have time to do that. And bringing this idea into current times, again, you need to have time in order to learn a lot of stuff from different topics. It is difficult to work in one job and then jump to another job. It is possible, but it is difficult. I know what I'm talking about because I do it from time to time. Another group of people are multipotentials, multipotentialities, or another name are generalists. These are people who have interest in different various topics and they invest themselves in these topics to some degree. They don't necessarily have to be a specialist in some specific topic. Even I would go a little bit further, some people use specialist and this word multipotentialist, multipotential person. It is a very difficult word to say. Anyway, these two words as antonyms, so one is an opposite of another. The main difference between a multipotential person and a person who is a polymath is what level of excellency you need to achieve in order to be some form of knowledgeable person in this field. For polymath, you need to be kind of a specialist. For multipotential person, you need to know some stuff about the field. How much? I mean, it is not defined how much you need to know to be a specialist, but how much you need to know to become a polymath, multipotential person, it is obviously also not that clear. But in my opinion, in order to be a multipotential person, you need to be interested in different topics and different fields of the world and be able to learn the information from these fields on the basic level pretty quickly and qualitatively good and comprehend information, use that information for different fields and being able to use one information in order to learn the different information. That all makes you a multipotential person. And in order to become a polymath, you need to become a better multipotential person. So there is a saying that in each multipotential person is a potential for a polymath. So each multipotential person can become a polymath if that person will go deeper in different fields and become and achieve something. So if you provide some achievements from this field, which information that you use from different fields, yes, that makes you a polymath, not only a multipotential, but also a polymath. Why did I decide to talk about this topic? Because I want to talk about myself. To be honest, I learned about the word polymath some time ago and I was like, ooh, that sounds a little bit like me. But now, soon as I understood that you need to actually achieve and be to achieve something in the fields in order to be a polymath, you need to be a some form of specialist, I would not be ready to claim myself a polymath, because I'm not sure how much of knowledge you need to have in order to be a specialist. So I know that I have a lot of knowledge from various topics, various fields, and I use this knowledge for different fields and I apply knowledge from one field for a different one. But I'm not sure whether I'm a specialist because of that. I think my idea of I'm not a specialist comes from understanding or maybe from expectation which I have for specialists. In my eyes, specialist is a person who knows about stuff. So who knows about stuff that the person is talking about and understands also the all behinds and all arounds and at least know where to look up information and know that this information exists about the topic. And although I am like that in some fields, to some degree, I wouldn't call myself a specialist on a high level. At least nowadays, at least yet. Maybe in the future, but now I don't think I'm that specialized. Yeah. But I think I can call myself a multi-potential person. I was always interested in different topics. Yes, there are topics that I'm not interested in. There always will be something like, for example, history. I'm not that interested in history. I'm sometimes interested in what happened during history, but not in the date stuff or like, for example, some war stuff. I was and am still really, really, really bad at history. Also, for a person who traveled a lot and move from one place to another place, I am pretty bad at geography, to be honest with you. Again, in comparison to whom, but overall I'm not so good at geography and I mix up countries a lot. However, overall, I am interested in different topics. I do learn different stuff as much as I can or as much as I find information about something that I find possibly interesting, and I also look forward to learning new skills when I have time for that, when I have an ability to do that, or sometimes when I have time and money for that. For example, I will go back to playing piano. I learned how to do it during my early years, young years, and I want to go back to it so I can bring this level a little bit higher. And then I want to bring level of piano playing a little bit higher. Also, I want to upload my singing of different voices, so basically a cappella alone on TikTok. So that is that field. Then we have some fields like dancing. I'm interested in capoeira. Then we have like medicine and biology and psychology and philosophy and design and informatics, so front-end development. So I'm working in that field and I want to go further in that field. So yes, there are quite a lot of fields that I'm interested in on to some degree. And I think it allows me to call myself this multi-potential person. I have potentials in different fields, kinda. And also, if you will look into multi-potential article in the Wikipedia, you will find a lot of stuff like what is a multi-potential person normally is and what are negatives of being a multi-potential person. And there I read the most true things that I have currently in my life. Multi-potential people are bored like really regularly, and I am bored very, very quickly and very, very often. I don't think it is a good thing, but it is a part of my life. That's pretty much it. If you didn't know about multipotentiality and polymath, write in a comment. I didn't know about it. Or if you want to know more, then write in a comment. I will look on Wikipedia about it. Yay. Overall, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you learned something new. Maybe you learned something new about yourself. If you enjoyed the video, please drop a like. You can also subscribe to the channel. And except for that, I see you on Thursday. Have a great week.